So my name is Jasper Thibault. I am soil scientist at the Carrington Research Extension Center with NDSU. This afternoon, I'll be presenting on corn response to nitrogen. Now, there are several studies we have done within the past 8 years, and we have found that when nitrogen is applied, nitrogen fertilizer is applied to corn in the Carrington area, especially within the NDSU, Carrington Research Extension Center research sites, the response has been very weak compared to responses at other sites, despite the fact that the nitrogen content in the soil, the total nitrogen, is usually very low, somewhere below 30 pounds per acre. We have taken data from 9 site years. So 2 sites, a high yielding site at Oaks, still in North Dakota, and here in Carrington, we have looked at the data to see how the crop has been responding to nitrogen, where yields have been maximized, and where profits will be maximized. Now, it is important because previous nitrogen recommendations used to be based on yield goal. However, the recommendations were modified so that farmers should be focusing on maximizing profit, taking into consideration the response of yields to nitrogen rates as well as the price of corn, rather than fertilizing their corn based on yield goals. Now, the problem with yield goal is that the response, when you apply fertilizer to the crop based on that, at the end of the year, many a times we see that the corn either did not respond to nitrogen or the amount of nitrogen applied was too high. So it is very important that farmers retain this information that the nitrogen recommendations are based on the maximum profit for a long term. Change from the previous recommendation is that recommendations are not linked directly to expected yield. Nitrogen recommendations are based on an economic production function that accounts for the yield response of corn to other nitrogen, minus the cost of nitrogen. This recommendation system is called the return to nitrogen approach. That will show how corn has been responding to nitrogen and the estimated nitrogen amount of nitrogen to apply to maximize yield, to produce maximum yield, is different from the point where maximum profit is attained. So farmers can make the most profit by applying less nitrogen and even obtaining less yield compared to applying high amount of nitrogen, higher yield, but less profit. So this has not just the economic implication, but also has environmental implications, that by not applying nitrogen that may not be needed by the crop, you are preventing or you are avoiding situations where nitrogen may be lost through leaching in the soil.